In this video, I want to take you with me back to the beginning of the whole SUX project. Now, it's nearly 8 years ago till I get in touch with the first Su-47 styrofoam jet. So, and now come with me and see how all this year begins. Come! Exactly how my first experience with the sweet little Su-47 looks like. There was a very long start run, then it goes steep in the air and suddenly it was uncontrollable and crashes down. But I begin to integrate a gyro into the jet to make it more comfortable to fly, and this really works well. So let's see how the steps go up and up by becoming this Su-47 under control. Let's see. Yes, and after many crashes and fails, I started to understand the behavior of the Su-47, and so I could adjust the gyro that was absolutely necessary to fly this jet normally at justice in the right way, and also find the right movements of the servos and all these fine little settings that are so important to bring this crazy airplane or crazy jet to a normal flight. And after this was achieved, I begin with the experimental part, because I had the vision to let this Su-47 stand still in the air like a hummingbird. Yes, and at first I used the vector nozzles and put it against the wind, and it stands there like I want to. But the idea came to me to do this also in a normal flight position. And to make this possible, I started experimenting with swiveling ducts. These two parts here are really historic. These are the first 70mm EDF ducts I built on my own. These are normal 70mm EDFs with customized inbuilt head motors, because they are very powerful. Yes, and in the following pictures I like to show you how this looks like. Yeah, this Su-47 customized by this swiveling ducts. But this doesn't work so well, because when the jet slows down, it was not possible to control the jet into the air, because when it starts standing still, it falls down from the sky, because there was no control surface, nothing that could stabilize it. And so it became necessary to put some more EDFs into the jet. Altogether, I figured out that it makes the most sense when I put three of them into, like you see here on the SUX vertical, one EDF in front of the swiveling ducts and two fans behind. So it was possible to control all three axes and let this jet stay still in the air. But if it was that far, it was a long way. But here I want to show you a lot of my EDFs I built and adjust, and I spent so many time and hours just in building and testing EDFs, but this was necessary to find the absolute perfect match for my jet. Yes. Yes, the vision of a VTOL S-47 was born, and now I figured out which was the best position of these EDFs. For that, I built up a lot of test beds and hovered hundreds, felt hundreds of hours to see which are the best EDF for this and which are most efficient. Here are some pictures, you can see them. And after I had this combination with this three EDFs around the swivel ones, I put them in the styro S-47, and in this clip you can see the very very first hover in, I think it was February 2014. Yes, and so the retold story of this jet began. So this was the first part, how I get from the styrofoam SU-47 to the SUX in composites. I hope you enjoyed this small little video, and we see us in the next one. So have a nice day and bye bye.